Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can make your conversation with ChatGPT and any AI much more interesting. Normally, when you talk to it, you are using a chat-like interface, which is quite easy to use. However, the problem is that once the conversation evolves over a certain period of time, you have quite a lot of information that you have to keep track of. So the conversation may kind of get stuck on a certain point or idea, and you might not know how to develop it further. It's the same problem with other tools like WriteSonic in this instance. You just have a text, a chat, and then once you covered a certain range of concepts, it becomes difficult to come out of a certain loop that you get into with AI. So today I'm going to show you how you can escape this loop, how you can make ChatGPT or any AI system unstuck using a combination of data visualization, graph theory, and text analysis tools. Here we have a tool which is called InfraNodus. So you can see it here on the screen. And the way that it works is that it has a built-in ChatGPT, GPT-4 module, which enables you to engage in a conversation with ChatGPT here. So you can use this editor and have a conversation in a chat-like mode that we all find quite comfortable, just like in the other tools that we have. However, the big difference here is that you get a direct visual feedback on your conversation. So the words or the concepts that you use are visualized as the nodes in the graph, and when they occur in the same context, they will be closer to each other and they will have the same color. This representation allows you to quickly see what are the main ideas in a conversation. So for example, here I see I've been talking a lot about model and context and conversation and input prompts. So I get a really clear overview of the main ideas, and also I see the main topic. So how I was using those terms contextually. And I can see that, for instance, here I used some terms like face recognition and models used for that, input periphrasing, network making, and so on. So here I actually can identify the names of these topics using built-in GPT-3 and text analysis tools. So I can quickly see what were the main subjects of the conversation. And imagine if I come back to this conversation after a few hours or after a few days, if I had something like this, it would be necessary for me to read everything. Or if I had something like this, you know, I would have to read everything and kind of understand what it was about. And if I get stuck somewhere, it's the same problem. I have to reread the whole thing and kind of try to see where I can develop it further. Here, I have direct visual live overview of what I'm talking about. So I can quickly see how I can develop this conversation further. And usually it means that I will either focus on the subjects that are important to me, like for instance, I will get back to talking about context and model and different prompts that are used to contextualize what I'm querying an AI system for. This is what this conversation was about. So I can quickly get to that, or alternatively, I can also choose to develop a periphery of this graph. And for example, focus on some topics that I covered only for a short period of time, select them, and then try to develop my discourse further. So as you can see, it allows me to find some topic that is at the periphery of my discourse, and then generate a prompt which will make the model respond with some interesting ideas that will help me develop this discourse in this direction further. So for instance, here I'm selecting these nodes, randomness generated text, hard anticipate. Let's also select a word model so it understands that we're talking about AI models. And then I have several ways to approach it. I can either use the chat mode here. So I will just click save and it's going to send these nodes as a prompt to GPT 3.5 in this case. You can also use GPT-4, which is more precise, but takes a bit longer. Okay, and there I have a response and it kind of comes up with really good results. And as you can see, it highlights what it just added and it touched upon these topics, which I selected here, but also added a bunch of new interesting concepts that were not there before. And it says here that, for example, when fine-tuning GPT-like models, you can use a combination of hard and soft custom prompts to train the AI on specific context. So it's a very precise response about modulating the randomness of an AI model, which is really great because it picks up a conversation that we had and brings it in an interesting direction. Something that would take me a long time with a chat transcript like this or like that, you know? So this is one way to do that. You could just select some nodes and send it as a prompt. Also in InfraNodus, you have this nice AI insight panel, which basically identifies the gaps in the discourse for you and proposes you to make connections between them. And my favorite mode is the question mode. So instead of having the AI model generate content for me, I ask it to generate a research question that would link those different clusters of ideas together in an interesting way and propose me a question that would make me think further in this direction. So for instance, here it's trying to link a cluster on sentence making, which is here, and question phrasing, which is here. They are near each other, but they're not so well connected. So this is why InfraNodus is proposing me to think of a connection between them. You know, and if I click here, question, then it's going to generate a question linking those two concepts together. And then I can reiterate and choose other gaps and clusters as well. So for example, here, it's talking about the impact of using varying phrasing, multiple images and randomness in prompts to make the response of the model a bit more diverse, right? And even adding some image-based queries so I can increase the level of diversity of the responses in the model. If I don't like the insights, I can regenerate them or go to generate more insights, and then it will discover more gaps in the network and propose me to generate content that would link those gaps together. So one approach is focusing on the periphery, like we did here. I selected some nodes in this area on the edge of the discourse and asked the model to generate some content, or focusing on the gaps. And this is exactly what this module does. It kind of takes you through all the gaps and topics and tries to think of some interesting connections between them. Of course, you don't have to use the question mode. You can also use direct GPT-4 query that would connect these ideas together. So you can also do that. And then if you are a little bit more advanced on text analytics, you can even go into the analytics panel here and go into gap insights and use the functionality here that it identifies a gap. And then you can reiterate through a few gaps. And the further is the distance, the more interesting ideas you will get. So here it's, for example, proposing to connect the cluster on face recognition and using AI models for face recognition to different ways of phrasing your input prompts, right? And here is the gap. It shows it with the pink highlight here. And if I click there, it's going to generate a set of questions that would link these two ideas together. So you have these two ways of approaching it, either through this AI helper model or through the analytics panel here on the right. And for instance, here it's asking, what is the optimal input prompt, question phrasing and randomness to achieve a high false recognition threshold in facial recognition language models using broad scale API? So at the first glance, something that is kind of difficult to make sense of, but in fact, it relates to the main topic of my conversation, because I was asking the model about how we can generate content which is a bit more poetic and artistic. And for instance, we were talking about face recognition modes where you don't recognize a face or where you make a false recognition as a kind of artistic direction for the development of this idea. And that's exactly what it comes up with. If I like the question, that's a very interesting part, I can save it into the graph. And if I'm in the chat mode here in the editor, what's going to happen is that GPT-4, 3.5 in this case, which is used in ChatGPT also, will answer the question that it itself generated. So you make the model talk to itself, but you are the one steering this conversation, choosing the parts of the discourse which you find are important to develop further with the graph or with these text analytics tools on the right, and then it will generate highly relevant responses which are far from generic, far from what you would normally get. Because if you use an interface like this, it will usually just feed the whole conversation to ChatGPT and your last prompt, and then generate some content that might be interesting or not, but usually it will settle on a certain idea and reiterate it. I think you had experience yourself with this yourselves when you use ChatGPT or other tools. Here, you're actually avoiding this repetition loop by selecting the ideas on the graph, selecting the gaps on the graph, and then generating some content that would bridge those gaps, generating interesting questions, then sending them to GPT 3.5 or GPT-4 model, asking it to respond in some interesting ways. So here it's asking, how can machine learning be leveraged to generate creative artistic visuals from the underlying patterns learned from the combination of abstract text and generated content? Strange but interesting question. And here it's proposing me a response where it's talking about style transfer algorithms. So it's great because I would never get to this level of nuance and specificity if I just continued this conversation in a normal way. How would I know to connect those ideas together? And the graph and text analytics, they allow me to do exactly that, to connect those disconnected ideas in an interesting way and generate some questions that would then steer our interaction with AI in a direction that can enhance the whole discourse. So this is how it works. Feel free to try it out on InfraNodus.com. It has a built-in GPT-3, 3.5, GPT-4 models, which also power ChatGPT. So instead of using ChatGPT, you can just use InfraNodus, have the conversations, and then use this direct visual feedback and text analytics to generate new interesting content. And what's great is that your conversations are saved, so you can come back to them anytime, just like I did now, and pick up where you have left before and develop them further in an interesting direction. You can even connect different conversations together because you can combine different graphs here. So I can combine this conversation with some other conversation I had, for example, on the notion of sublime. I link them together. Here it shows me how they intersect, what are the common points, and exactly the same way, I can now generate some interesting questions that connect those two different conversations in an interesting way. But this will be a topic for another video. I'm just showing you that there's a lot of possibilities that you get by using the graph to analyze and visualize these conversations. Try it out on InfraNodus.com and let me know if you have any questions. Thank you.